In this segment, we'll talk about what a symmetric matrix is. So a square matrix A is called symmetric if Aij is equal to Aji for all I comma j. So the first thing which we have to understand, A is a square matrix, the same number of rows, the same number of columns. Then the ith row, jth column has to be same as the jth row, ith column for all the values of I comma j. So that's when we consider the matrix to be symmetric. We can also look at it this way, so it's another definition. If if it's a square matrix, transpose is same as the matrix itself. So if we have an n by n matrix, a square matrix, and we take the transpose of that and the same as the matrix itself, then A is symmetric. So this is the alternate definition of it, which means the same thing as the previous definition, but some people like to look at this definition that, hey, if I take a transpose of a square matrix, it's same as the original matrix, then A is considered to be symmetric. Let's look at an example here. Let's take a 3x3 matrix, so it's a square matrix. So it's 21, minus 3, minus 7, minus 3, minus 7, 6, 3, 2, and 2, let's suppose. So what we are finding out here is that we have a 3x3 matrix. Let's see whether it is symmetric or not. Now, we don't have to worry about the diagonal elements because the row number and the column number is the same for each of these diagonal elements. So those are going to be equal anyway. So if I switch the row number and column number of 21, it is still the first row, first column. So there's no need to check that. But I need to check the elements which are not on the diagonal. So if I look at this element right here, this is first row, second column. This is second row, first column. That's the same. This is first row, third column. This is third row, first column. They are the same. And then I have second row, third column, and I have third row, second column. They are also the same. So this one is the same as this one, this one is same as this, and this one is same as this, and that's what makes this symmetric. So if I had to write it down, I will say that A12, which is minus 3, is same as A21. So the first row second column is minus 3, is same as the second row first column. A13 is minus 7, first row third column is same as A31, third row first column. And then I have A23 is 2, and third row second column is 2 also, so they are equal. So that's what makes this A matrix to be a symmetric matrix. And that is the end of this segment.